Before I do this, let me get rid of most of my stuff.
Get the ingredients in that vessel and let me know when you're ready.
I tried to get her along, but that ain't going to work. So I will just drop the shit that I have. Just in case we find some loot in the CERN, probably. Most likely, to be honest.
Can I help you? Divine smile on you, friend. Riverwood's agreeable enough, I suppose. For a Nord village.
Get the ingredients in that vessel and let me know when you're ready. Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood. Of course. What is it? I've been asking myself the same thing since we came back to the castle. She was so sure of what we did to my father. I couldn't help but go along with her. I never thought of the cost. Possibly. I guess even a vampire mother is still a mother. She worried about me. About all of us. But she wanted to get me as far away from my father as possible before he really went over the edge. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I just didn't expect anyone to care how I felt about her. Thank you. Are we ready then? All right. Here goes.
All right, that looked painful.
Now that I think about it, I should have expected that. Sorry. It's hard to describe. The Soul Cairn is... well, hungry, for lack of a better word. It's trying to take your life essence as payment. There might be, but I don't think you're going to like it. Vampires aren't counted among the living. I could probably go through there without a problem. Not your first choice, I guess? Maybe. We could just pay the toll another way. It wants a soul, so we give it a soul. Yours. My mother taught me a trick or two. I could partially soul trap you and offer that gem to the ideal masters. It might be enough to satisfy them. It would make you a bit weaker when we travel through the Soul Cairn, but we might be able to fix that once we're inside. Maybe. I'm sorry. I wish I knew a better way, something that would be easier for you. Just know that whatever path you choose, I won't think any less of you. Sometimes things just have to be done. I know that better than anybody. Well, looks like some other guests. Are you sure? I'm willing to do it, but you need to think it through. You'll remain mortal, but you'll find yourself weakened within the Soul Cairn. I know this is difficult for you. I hope you trust me. I'd never do anything that could hurt you. Oh. Good. I promise to make this as painless as possible. Hold still.
Do I need to collect those things? I'm just gonna collect them just to be safe. This area looks bad. Huh.
There.
did you come from?
One thousand steps, and a thousand more.
Jesus. How big is this area? I think he's stuck. Yup. Maybe that will fix it.
Let's keep going. I think we're being watched. Hunger, weary, feel anything, loneliness. Who's there?
This area is massive, holy shit.
What do you want? How does anyone expect me to write my opus with all of these rude interruptions? What do I mean, indeed? If I hadn't lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament, and we wouldn't be having this conversation. I suppose a moment or two of my time couldn't hurt. I am Jib. Some call me Saint Jib. Others call me Jib the Eradicator. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Yup, Morrowind.
I can't say that I'm surprised by your answer. Until I get my second volume published, no one will ever know of my achievements. I'd hardly call a 26-volume epic simply a book. Surely you've heard of the rise and fall of Saint Jib the Eradicator, hero of Morrowind and savior of the Dunmer. Terrible. Simply terrible. I was in the midst of writing the second volume, and they just threw me into this prison. It's unfair. That damned Remora and his minions. They didn't even give me a chance to explain who I was. Well, I assume so. They cast a spell at me from Some kind of strange black crystal. Next thing I arrived here. My what? Wait. No. All these wasted months. Years. I don't even remember how much time has passed. Now my work will never see the light. My name will be forgotten. Perhaps. Maybe I can't be what my writings can. In order to write the second volume of my opus, I need the notes from my first volume. Otherwise, I need to do all of this from memory. When I was tossed, I felt myself falling, and I dropped the pages I had been holding. There were 10 of them. Find them for me, please. I beg you. Ah, yes. Saint Jip. Jip the Eradicator. Jip the Magnificent. I've earned a lot of those titles thanks to my campaign against the Winged Menace. Yes, I'm speaking of the Cliff Racer, of course. Wretched things. They used to crisscross the skies over Morrowind like vermin. Nasty flying creatures with a habit of sneaking upon the unwary. After I was freed from prison, I decided to turn my life around. Give something back to the people of Morrowind. It became quickly apparent that the best way I could help would be by wiping out the Cliff Racers. Indeed I was. I hunted down and killed every last one of them. Took years. The people of Morrowind were so grateful to have the roads safer again, they took to calling me Saint Jipan. Then the other names followed. Well, that's a ridiculous question. Everyone traveling through here has said that the Oblivion Gates have been opening all over Tamria. Has it been that long? Oh my. Well, it started with the followers of Mehrunes Dagon having Emperor Uriel Septimus VII assassinated. Without a septum on the throne of the Empire, Dagon was able to leave Oblivion through the gates and attack. All I heard is that without a septum sitting on the throne of the Empire, the dragon fires in a place called the Temple of the One were no longer lit. This meant that we were vulnerable to the forces of Oblivion. Well, I don't know. Everything seemed fine until that remora attacked me. I only heard later about the gates from the other souls. I can only assume the gates have been closed by now. That was a dark time in my life. I did a lot of things I ended up regretting. Maybe that's why I worked so hard to redeem myself once I was freed. I murdered others for money. And before you think I belong to some romantic or secretive guild, think again. I was simply an addict who needed money for skooma. The stuff wasn't cheap, and murder always seemed to be in demand. Finally bit off more than I could chew. I was paid to assassinate some high-ranking official from House Redoran. What I didn't know is someone had hired the Morag Tong to kill him as well. Exactly. He got to my target first and called the guard to cover his tracks. By the time I got there, the place was on alert. Walked right into a trap, and didn't even realize it until I was captured. They tried me for murder, threw me on a prison ship, and sent me to the jail in Vivek City. Gave me a lot of time to think, that's for sure. I had just moved from my ancestral home in Morrowind to the continent of Sindin. I settled in the city of Kavach to write my memoirs and to find some peace and quiet. Indeed, one moment I was writing diligently, and the next, my door bursts open. It was a cadre of Dremora. The city was under attack. I took it upon myself to join the Dremora and fight the Dremora, thinking this would simply be another feather in my cap. The reason I'm standing in front of you is only a whisper of my former self should tell you that. I never knew what became of Kavach. I wonder if